Among the countless terrors of the 41st millennium, there is perhaps no greater threat to the survival of mankind than the Tyranid Hive Fleets, gigantic swarms of bioorganic starships and spacefaring creatures capable of traversing the intergalactic void to strip worlds of all biological matter, augmenting their own evolution and leaving entire galaxies desolate in their wake. Hive Fleets are comprised of a nearly endless variety of vessels, with each hive's aesthetic differing wildly based on the life forms it has consumed. At the heart of the fleet are the Tyranid Hive ships, enormous starships which act as control nodes for the entire swarm. Each single hive ship features miles upon miles of spawning pits, producing vast numbers of Tyranids and smaller bioships at all times to maintain and expand the hive fleet. Though generally slow and ungainly, hive ships are nevertheless extremely powerful in battle, boasting hundreds of densely clustered weapon growths dotted along their surface, and featuring thick layers of stony chitinous armour capable of absorbing massive amounts of damage. The individual ships which make up Tyranid Hive Fleets are not capable of reaching faster than light velocities, with the fleet instead relying on a spacefaring creature known as a Narvhal to effectuate interstellar and intergalactic travel. The Narvhal is an unarmed and poorly armoured bioship, which is capable of sensing the gravity well of a solar system from pangalactic distances. When the hive mind decides upon a particular system to attack, the Narvhal creates a corridor of compressed space, which harnesses and amplifies the natural gravity of the system's celestial bodies to pull the entire fleet through the compression field to reach their target. Though this method is slower than the warp travel employed by the Imperium, it is far more reliable, and features an interesting side effect which is highly advantageous to the Hive. When the Narvhal anchors itself to a solar system's gravity, that system's worlds begin to suffer catastrophic natural disasters and anomalies, weakening and disorganizing their populations on the advent of a Tyranid invasion. Aside from the Hive ships and the Narvhal, a Tyranid Hive Fleet's most vital assets are its cruisers. Most Tyranid cruisers are either undeveloped Hive ships or escort drones that have grown to a far greater size. Cruisers do not serve as synaptic nodes in the greater Hive mind, affording them a degree of expendability in battle, and the ships are equipped with large, hull-crushing claws and arrays of pyro-acid batteries to assist in defending the Hive from outside threats. Tyranid cruisers are employed in large numbers to surround and overwhelm the enemy, a tactic which has proven brutally effective on many occasions. But the ships are only capable of engaging at the shortest of ranges, as they require periodic return trips to the Hive to receive nourishment and synaptic reconnection. The threat represented by a Tyranid Hive Fleet is nothing short of apocalyptic. Due to their adaptive nature, a powerful resistance fought against the fleet will only serve to strengthen the Hive in the long term, and as a result, only the most extreme measures have proven consistently effective against them. One such tactic employed by the Imperium of Man is to draw a Hive Fleet into an extensive planet-side battle, forcing them to deploy as many ground forces as possible before rapidly evacuating the world and executing an exterminatus from high orbit, obliterating all organic material on the planet and rendering it permanently lifeless. Though this desolates the world in much the same way that the Tyranid forces intended, it robs the Hive of the biological energy it hoped to absorb from the planet, and which the fleet relies on to recover the energy spent in its attack. Only through such brutal tactics can a Hive fleet be deprived of its sustenance, and ultimately prevented from carrying its devastation further across the galaxy.